Pancreatic cancer is a particularly lethal form of cancer, in great part because it's often caught too late. But a new blood test shows promise in breaking that cycle. And to learn more, we welcome Dr. Madappa Kundranda. He's Division Chief of Cancer Medicine, Banner MD Anderson Cancer Center. Doctor, good to see you again. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you so much, Ted. This is
going to be a promising conversation, I can tell, because anything that helps with pancreatic cancer is a good thing.
Absolutely. So because when we look at pancreatic cancer, right, one of the biggest challenges with pancreatic cancer is, although the numbers show that 20% of pancreatic cancer patients are diagnosed at a point when they can be resected and cured from the disease, the true reality of it is 90% of pancreatic cancer cannot be, 90% of pancreatic cancer is more in the context of uncurable or incurable disease.
Why is it that way?
That's because of exactly what we're talking about today, which is the lack of early diagnosis and consistent early diagnosis that you could actually shift the staging to make it more of a curable disease as opposed to the incurable part of it.
So get it before it metastasizes, in other words.
Correct.
All right, let's talk about this blood test. What are we talking about?
So I think we've been looking at this for the last decade or so. We've had a lot of small studies that have shown promise, looking at specific proteins that can actually detect the metastases of the disease or even detect the disease before anything else can do that. So when we look at pancreatic cancer, you have two different cohorts that you're looking at. Those that have a higher risk for developing pancreatic cancer, we've developed some pretty decent tests to actually identify those earlier on. We tend to do MRIs, we tend to do EUSs, tend to do all of these invasive tests, but still end up detecting this earlier, catching it earlier, and potentially curing them off of them. However, that is only less than 5% of patients with pancreatic cancer. 95% of them is almost this de novo occurrence, which we do not have any good screening tests for. When you look at a screening test, you're looking at two things. One, is it non-invasive? And the second thing is it accurate enough that it can actually pick it up? And that's what this test is, one of the five tests that have actually come out in the last decade, which have, this test specifically looks at a breakdown of the proteins, which is detected in up to 90% of patients with pancreatic cancer, as opposed to a normal patient population wherein they do not have that protein that's being detected there.
So when I was looking at this, you're looking at changes in protease activity. Is that what you're talking about? Breakdown?
Correct.
Changes means breakdown, protease means proteins.
Yeah, so protease is the breakdown of the protein. You have enzymes, so protease, ACE is the enzyme that breaks down these proteins. So the normal body's mechanism is to actually break down some of these proteins, which for essence do not really serve a function.
Yes.
So those are proteases. This test actually detects these proteases, which are very specific to pancreatic cancer.
I was going to ask you, is it a specific breakdown, and is that breakdown specific to pancreatic cancer?
Correct, and that's what at least this study has demonstrated with regards to this. The key thing is to determine whether in a large scale study, whether this will still hold its own, and that is the part that I think needs to be investigated here.
And this differs from current tests. You kind of referred to current tests back there that they work especially for high risk, but not necessarily the other way. This differs overall how?
Correct. So we have this protein called the CA19-9, all right? It's what we call the CA19-9 is a protein that occurs for a multitude of reasons, but it's detected because it's produced by the layer within your bloodstream, within the pancreatic ducts. However, the problem is if you have pancreatitis or you have an inflammation of your pancreas or you have an inflammation of your biliary ducts, your CA19-9 can go up and that's a false positive. So in this case, this is something when you combine it with the CA19-9, which is again a protein biomarker, this actually increases the accuracy of diagnosing patients with pancreatic cancer.
What about patients with diabetes? Does that factor into how this is looking?
So with diabetes, it's a little bit tricky because some of the newer drugs that we have for diabetes can actually cause inflammation of your pancreas. So in some cases, you can actually have a false positive with regards to the CA19-9 that's elevated, especially with the GLP antagonists and all of those that we currently have in the market.
Now, I understand that for this blood test, you don't need vial after vial after vial, right, do you?
So this is one thing which requires a very small amount of blood, right? And blood draws, for the most part, are non-invasive. And the turnaround time is less than an hour.
Holy smokes, you can get it that quickly?
Exactly. So I think as long as we can validate this in larger studies, something which is non-invasive, which has got a quick turnaround time wherein you're not waiting 4 weeks to get the results, is certainly something that can be a screening test.
So that's next in research.
Correct.
Obviously, the research has to go on. When can something like this become available?
I mean, like previously when we've looked at drug development, right, it's taken us almost a decade. Now we are developing drugs within a year that are getting onto the market to help our patients. A test like this, based on how they factor in the clinical trial, that's going to be a more expanded trial, looking at this in a more larger patient population, could potentially be in the market in the next couple of years.
Next couple of years?
Right.
My goodness. Well, that a promising conversation. I knew it would be, and it is. And this is something to keep an eye out for, this blood test to detect pancreatic cancer early and get this thing fixed, because it's such a deadly disease. Doctor, yeah, good to have you here. Thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate the encouraging conversation.
Thank you so much for having me.
You bet.